Please come.
Good morning, sir. Good morning. Good morning, sir.
Okay, Darshan Prakash Chand. Good name, very long name. Darshan Prakash Chand Dugar.
Yes, sir.
Just tell me, Jains, your religion is Jain.
Yes, sir.
How many these surnames will be there? This Dugar is a subcaste, surname or what?
Sir, Dugar is a surname. It's not a subcaste. Subcaste is Marwadi, sir, under Jain. And under that, there are various Gotras, sir. So it is one of the Gotras.
Under Jainism, this is one of the Gotras.
Yes, sir.
So how many Gotras are there in Jainism?
Sir, I don't have exact idea of Gotras.
Okay. Tell me something about Jainism.
Sir, Jainism is an ancient religion which started, which is founded by the first Tirthankara, Lord Rishabhdeva. And the 24th Tirthankara was Lord Mahavira. And the basic philosophy of Jainism is non-violence. And the core rests on Anekantvad, philosophy of Anekantvad, sir.
Jainism, there are two sects, I think.
Yes, sir, there are two sects. Digambaras and Shvetambaras. They are further divided into, Shvetambaras are further divided into three subsects, sir. Murti Pujaks, Sthanakvasi, and Therapantis, sir.
In some of the sect, I heard that if somebody wants to go get moksha, then leave everything, food and all, and slow sort of moksha and death.
Sir, that is called as santhara. Santhara is taken when a person feels that all the purposes of life is served. He voluntarily gives up solid food and a liquid diet, and it is a gradual process. Person starts giving up the food and solid liquid intakes slowly when he feels that he's about to
okay. See, there is one Amaravati place, na?
Yes, sir.
And I read in newspaper that Amaravati Corporation has given some donations to BJP. Heard that?
No, sir.
You didn't read in the papers.
Sorry,
sir. Achha, anyway, whether any municipal corporation can also give donation to a political party?
Sir, as of my knowledge, I think they cannot donate to a political party.
They cannot donate? See, in this particular news, what happened, what I read in the paper, it was not from the municipal corporation. It was the employees, some of the employees requested the corporation that please deduct this much amount from our salary and give it to BJP. Whether that can be done?
Sir, that can be done if employees want to voluntarily contribute for a political party or any organization. They can do it on voluntary basis, sir.
But it is done by the corporation, deducting from the salary.
Sir, corporation should not deduct the salary. Instead, employees can be instructed to donate on their individual.
Collection can be made.
Yes,
okay. You are a civil engineer. And once you come to this administrative service, you are a collector of one place, and you have been directed by the government that you have to establish a new, set up a new town,
yes,
new
sir.
Town,
yes,
nearby
sir.
Area, and you have to design roads and buildings. So tell me 4-5 factors which you will keep in mind for designing these roads and buildings.
Sir, foremost factor will be acquiring the land for the persuading the people who have their lands in that area, then doing the reconnaissance survey, sir, to find out the to have the clear idea of geography and the resources available in the region.
My main question is, you being a civil engineer,
yes,
for designing the roads and buildings, what factors will keep in mind? Important factors.
Yes, sir. Sir, bearing capacity of soil will be one of the factors. Along with that, sir, which kind of foundation will be suitable there, and after foundations are availability of the resources and the wind loads and earthquake considerations can also be taken, sir. If it is a earthquake prone region and if it falls under the zone 5, then it is necessary to go for an earthquake resistant design, sir. And wind loads also, sir.
Drainage will not be doing anything?
Oh, yes, sir. Drainage will also.
That is a major problem in any city being developed?
Yes, sir. Drainage is also one of the important factors, sir. I forgot to mention. Sorry, sir.
Okay. In the civil services, you know about the civil services because you have been appearing? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Which is the highest level you can reach?
Sir, highest level is. Sir, I don't know about exact highest level, sir. Sorry, sir.
Darshan, can you tell me the different races in India?
Yes, sir. Sir, Dravidian, sir, Mongoloid, Negrito, Proto-Astroloid, and in Mongoloid also, sir, there are Tibeto-Mongoloid and two divisions, sir, in Mongoloid.
Which is the most prominent race in the country?
Sir, most prominent race in the country is, sir, Dravidian race, sir.
Dravidian race. Can you tell me, there is something called as a hunter-gatherer personality.
Yes, sir.
Right. What traits of hunter-gatherer do we still retain? Are we still having some traits of hunter-gatherer?
Sir, hunter-gatherer society were primarily based on the principle of cooperation and coordination between them, sir. So, that is one of the traits we possess in these times also, sir. In terms of in sociological terms, sir, as a society we cooperate with each other, as we observed during the second wave of pandemic, or we observe coordination between different ministries, different departments, and between private and government organizations.
Okay, so evolution is a continuous process.
Yes.
So is it still happening?
Yes, sir.
So what is the next line of evolution that we can expect in humans?
Sir, next line of evolution, there could be loss of wisdom teeth, which is disappearing in most of the population, sir.
Why is it happening?
The rate of evolution has increased due to the increased number of mutants, sir. Mutagens, increased exposure to carcinogens like X-rays or.
Has wisdom tooth anything to do with our food habits?
Yes, sir. It has connection with our food habits also, sir. The diet which we are taking, if we are having a singular or single type of diet for a long period of time, then our body starts to respond in a different way, sir. So that is also one of the factors, sir.
You have worked in Shapoorji Pallonji. There has been a controversy between Shapoorji Pallonji and Tata Group. Can you elaborate on this?
Cyrus Mistry was appointed as a CEO of Tata Sons Limited in 2012, and he was sacked from the post in 2016, removed from the post in 2016. The reason was he was not working as per Tata style of working or Tata way of working, sir. And he approached NCLAT. NCLAT ruled in the favor of Tata. He approached NCLT. NCLT ruled in favor of Tata's, and then he approached NCLAT. NCLAT ruled in favor of him. So issue boiled down to two main points, sir. It was he raised petition on the ground that minority shareholders are being suppressed. So recently, in the month of April, Supreme Court ruled that the provision in Companies Act provides protection to small shareholders, sir. And definition of small shareholder is anyone who is holding equity below below worth 20,000 is a small shareholder. So there can be place for representative of small shareholder on the board of directors. Minority shareholder do not get that protection.
There is also a controversy with respect to divesting investment of Shapoorji in Tata Trust. Are you familiar with this? Right. Can you tell me some major engineering companies in India?
Sir, major engineering
engineering companies are Larsen & Toubro Construction Limited, Hindustan Construction Limited, Gammon Construction Company, and
Central Vista project is being constructed by?
Central Vista is a project which will be implemented in phases. Currently, the construction of Parliament work has been awarded to Tata Projects Limited, sir.
Okay. Now the earlier Delhi is known as a Lutyens Delhi. So what can we call the new Delhi, new Parliamentary Vista region?
Sir, it will be called Central Vista itself.
Okay. So watching documentaries on Indian tribes, what was the last documentary you watched and what is your takeaway from it?
Sir, last documentary I watched on T-Tribes of Assam, sir. And my takeaways are, they are not being granted scheduled tribe status as they migrated in the British era there. So they belong to various scheduled tribe in other states like Mundas, Oraos, Gonds, Santals are working there in T states, sir. The issue of compensation, issue of wage still persists, sir. They are being paid paltry wages by the T state owners, and the indicators of health, education are very low among them, sir.
How has social media transformed the social interaction?
Sir, social media has brought everyone together on a same platform. Anyone from anywhere else can connect with each other. Like through the medium of Facebook or WhatsApp, Twitter, one can connect with people, one can connect with a person from different part of the world. So that is there, sir. It has led to exchange of thoughts, diffusion of thoughts and technology also, sir.
What is meant by Arni?
Sir, Arni means moving around, sir. Something circular, moving around something.
Why that your village is called Arni?
Sorry, sir. I do not know the exact reason behind that. Uh-huh. I tried to find it out, sir, but I didn't get one, sir.
Okay. What are all the criticisms against the India's government of India's proposal to have integrated theater commands?
Integrated theater commands. Sir, sorry, sir. Can you repeat the question once again?
You read news about integrated theater commands. So, do you believe that it will enhance our capabilities?
Sir, integrated theater commands are the commands which comprise of all the three units of our security forces, military, army, navy and air force, sir. And I believe that integration between them is important from the point of view of mobility of the forces, a greater maneuverability and greater coordination and cooperation between them, sir. In case of previous conflicts with Pakistan or China, we have observed that there was time lag between the mobility of the forces. So that can be avoided, and optimization can be done, sir, in defense expenditure, because they can have common resources. And
so flip side, anything?
Sir, as of now, I cannot think of any criticism, sir. Sorry, sir.
Okay. Tell me something about marginal monetary policy committee.
Sir, monetary policy committee is a committee which consists of three members from the Reserve Bank of India and three government members. These six members decide the monetary policy. They decide the policy rate of central bank, which is the repo rate. And recently we have...
What is the mandate for the Reserve Bank when they formulate monetary policy?
Sir, the basic mandate of Reserve Bank is to balance between the growth and inflation, sir. Maintain inflation within the range of 4%± 2%, and along with that, stimulate the growth.
When you say mandate, 4 plus or minus 2%, that is 2 to 6% they can range, isn't it? And recently we heard about some slippages also in this band, right?
Yes.
So, what will be the effect if why we fix this mandate? If it's RBI is not able to control the inflation within this time, limit, what will happen?
Sir, this mandate has two reasons, sir, main two reasons. Impact of inflation on the population, on the pockets of the consumers, and keeping the growth momentum as it is, sir. If inflation increases if inflation increases beyond 6%, sir, then there will be a change in monetary policy stance, which might make the borrowing cost dearer, sir. Which might increase the borrowing cost.
When RBI is failing the duty, right? If it is not able to control the inflation within this range, RBI is failing in its duty. Our monetary policy committee is not foreseeing these things. Is there any accountability? Is there any action that can be taken on RBI and its monetary policy and its members?
Yes, sir. There is accountability mechanism. The representatives of RBI have to give statement in front of parliamentary committee, sir, or in front of parliament, and there they put forward the agenda or plan of action that they will control the inflation.
You are also telling about RBI will change the stance. What do you mean by stance? What are all the types of stances?
There are three types of stances: neutral stance, accommodative stance, and a calibrated tightening stance, sir. So in the recently concluded meeting of RBI has left its stance unchanged to accommodate.
What do you mean by accommodative stance?
Accommodative stance, there can be accommodation for rate cut, sir. They might go for rate cut. In the neutral stance, there will be they might be increase or decrease in the rate. And in the calibrated tightening, sir, RBI walks on a tight rope. They increase the repo rate, sir.
The stance is relating to rate, interest rates, or something else? I am not able to understand. Stance is relating to fixing the rates, or when they fix the rate, we know what is the stance. It is fixing rates or some other activities of the RBI.
Multiple connotations, fixing rates and effect of fixing rates on the overall economy, sir. That by adopting accommodative stance, they try to give room for banks to extend loans.
Okay, this do you think Indian citizen can feel secure?
Yes, sir.
But Chief Justice of India says judges' complaints are being ignored by police and CBI. When a Chief Justice of India is saying this kind of statements against the police, indicating that judges are not safe, judicial functionaries are not safe, how can you say that the common citizen is safe?
Yes, sir. Sir, the statement of Chief Justice of India was in the context of the alleged murder of the judge of district judge of Jharkhand, one of the districts of Jharkhand. He was hit by auto driver owing to having judgment in some important cases. And the stance of Chief Justice of India is in a particular context, sir, and we cannot apply it on a larger scale, sir. If we look from broader perspective, citizens are secure, law and order situation is well, but there are some incidences, one-off incidences, sir, which we need to curb and ensure better policing and better law and order situation, sir.
What is matriarchy?
Matriarchy is the rule by females, or authority of females in a lineage, in a family. In a society.
Okay. Some of the northeast states have matriarchy in the tribal culture. Can you name the states?
Yes, sir. In Meghalaya, there is a matriarchy is practiced in Meghalaya, sir.
Meghalaya. Okay. Recently, Kargil and Leh have been demanding for safeguards under sixth schedule of the constitution. Can you tell me the reason why?
Sir, most of the population in Kargil and Leh belong to is tribal population, sir. And along with that, sir, their uniqueness of their culture, sir. And by demanding sixth schedule, they could get better protection. They could better protect their culture. They could get democratic developmental rights. Participatory democracy can be achieved to a greater extent, sir. As we have observed in the case of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, Mizoram.
Do you think fifth schedule and sixth schedule has been a success?
Sir, looking at the developmental parameters of scheduled tribe population, fifth and sixth schedule is a success to a large extent, sir. But there have been some issues which are being addressed by the government of the day, sir.
Okay. Can you comment on the religion of tribals?
Yes, sir. Sir, religion of the tribals compared to mainstream population, it consists of different practices, sir. Mainly, they are animism is there. There are different kind of practices, sir. Animism, along with that, manaism, animatism, then nature worship is there, ancestor worship is there. So these are different kinds of religious practices.
Why did we see so many conversions in tribal societies?
Sir, in recent years or in past?
In the last 100 years.
In the last 100 years, sir. Sir, it is mainly due to the work of missionaries and the organizations there. They work there and they have created a kind of rapport over there, and which attracted tribal people to embrace their religion due to health, education and other benefits, other facilities which they created there. Mostly, we have observed conversion in northeastern states, sir.
Can you tell me some government schemes which has made a considerable impact on the lives of tribals?
Sir, the main scheme is Tribal Subplan, sir, which is renamed as a Scheduled Tribe component in 2017, sir. It is one of the important component. And after that, sir, Eklavya Model Residential Schools, Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalayas are there. Then initiatives of TriFed, which enables tribal to market their products, which help them in value addition of their products.
Can you tell me something more of tribal subplans?
Yes,
sir. Tribal subplan is a plan for rapid socio-economic development of tribals. It mandates that the resources which are being spent on tribals should be in proportion to the tribal population, sir. It basically focuses on capacity building and human development indicators of tribals, sir. Education, health, sanitation, and connectivity of tribal hamlets to the main roads and all, sir.
Does genetics have a role in modern sports?
Sir,
what is your opinion?
Genetics do play a role in modern sports, sir. But its impact has to be its impact has to be utilized in that way, sir. Genetic may play 20% role, but it is up to the individual to utilize or to bank on that genetic trait, sir.
And sports policy also affects the performance, or only the genetics?
Sir, genetics is there, but sports policy and overall sports ecosystem in the country is also responsible for the development of sports, sir.
What is National Infrastructure Pipeline?
National Infrastructure Pipeline is a project, sir. Project to invest around 102 lakh crore rupees by 2024 in to create infrastructural facilities in the various domains, sir, be it social, physical or digital infrastructure, sir.
Okay. Why do you want to join civil services?
Sir, my primary motive to join civil services is I was exposed to service orientation since childhood, sir. That was there. And another factor is the challenging nature of job. diversity of roles which I will be getting to perform in civil services, and sustainability and security of the service, sir. Better perks, better salary. These are
sustainability and security of the services. So it's a permanent job. Don't you think it has rather made a negative impact on the efficiency and effectiveness of civil servants?
In my opinion, it is up to the individual which way he wants to look at the permanency of the service. If we look it from brighter side, individual can bring bigger changes. Individual can bank on that permanency of the service. But in some cases, it has impacted negatively also, sir. Where the individuals are not performing good, or they are acting in violation of the rules or conduct rules of civil services, sir.
One last question: what is accommodative stance by RBI? What do you mean by accommodative stance?
Sorry, sir, I'm not able to recall.
Hawkish stance.
Sorry, sir.
Okay. Darshan, your interview is over.